We're going to discuss about the concurrent execution and the concurrent programming, and this is a part of database management system. First of all, we need to understand why do we actually need concurrent execution. So what is concurrent execution? Is that if there's one single data item which is present, if this is a data item, then more than two people can work on this data item simultaneously. And because more than two people are working on the same data item simultaneously, so you can increase the throughput of the system. That means throughput means more number of jobs can be completed per unit time. So why do we need concurrent execution is number one, for avoiding longer waiting times. Right. So because in case of serial execution, if for example you have 5 or 6 jobs, J1, J2, J3 up to so on, there are some specific number of jobs. If you are going to execute these jobs serially, then on serial execution, after finishing one job, then only you can start the another job. For example, if you started with the job J3, after finishing the job J3, then only we can start job J2. After finishing the job J2, then only we can start job J1. Now, if both these jobs are not in overlapping, they are not overlapping with each other, then there is no problem whatsoever, right? So, for example, if this is a bank account, and in this bank account, I can deposit some funds, and even someone else also can also deposit some funds simultaneously, and they do not have to wait for each other, right? But it can create some issues that we will be studying. But just now understand that to complete a job, if one person is doing a job, then we can make it faster if two or more people are working on the same data items or same same job simultaneously. So we want to avoid longer waiting times. That means we do not want to wait for a longer duration. Like you can see one more example of railway reservation system. In railway reservation system, if someone is trying to reserve some seats, then if two or more people are working simultaneously, if we just allow one person to reserve a seat at one time, then it will take years just to service all the people, because right now there are approximately 7500 people who can reserve the tickets at the same time, exactly at the same moment. Within per second, railway Indian Railways is allocating 7500 tickets. Now, so because if these people can work simultaneously, or can say parallelly, then we can service them better and they do not have to wait for a longer duration of time. And second is, if a transaction involves multiple steps, like we have execution of the transaction, we have IO operation, then we have during IO operation CPU could be utilized to execute the other transaction, right? So what does it mean? It means to say, like, if we know that for a process, or you can say for a transaction, a transaction may require two types of operation. Number one is the CPU operation, and second one is the IO operation. CPU operation is the operation where the transaction is performing some task inside the CPU, and IO operation is the operation where the transaction is performing some kind of input output, like it is taking input from the user or it is giving some kind of output from the user. Now, when the transaction is doing the CPU time, that means the transaction is busy and the CPU is utilizing. You are utilizing the CPU and CPU is not sitting idle. But if the transaction is doing the IO time, that time the CPU is sitting idle and we are not executing any task at that time. Okay, so you can see, because a transaction involves multiple steps, so if a transaction is doing input output, then simultaneously we can bring some other process inside the CPU to execute at the same time. Okay, and by doing so, by doing the concurrent execution, we are going to increase the CPU utilization as well as the disk utilization. Okay, so this is the reason why we use concurrent execution. Next is, what is a schedule? Schedule means, if for example two transactions are working parallelly, for example if this is a bank account, this is one person, maybe this is Himanshu, and this is another person, maybe this is Ravi. Now Himanshu and Ravi both are trying to deposit some funds in the same account number, right? And how they are going to allocate, because for every deposition we are going to have three types of statements, then how they are going to follow this schedule, or can say, and then how they are going to perform these operations, and the sequence of those operations is going to define a schedule. So you can say a schedule is, it represents the order in which the operations of a transactions are executed. Operation of a transactions are executed. Okay, so that is called as a schedule. Now these are some problems which can be related to the concurrent execution, and these problems are related to we may lose some kind of data items while performing these transactions parallelly, and we'll be looking at all these operations one by one. And the first operation is called as the lost update problem, and which is due to write conflict. Let me tell you what is lost update problem. Okay, so it occurs when two transactions try to write a data item one after another without a read of that data item between. Okay, so see, if you are performing some kind of operation, maybe you are performing a is a data variable, so a is equal to a plus 50. Now this kind of operation is, when you convert this operation to assembly language, then this kind of operation is generally broken down to three parts. Number one is the read operation, that means you are going to load R naught comma the value of a, and this a can be any memory location. Like this statement can also be written like this: load R naught comma 3000, where 3000 is the memory location. So that is saying that before performing any operation, we have to load this data item onto the register R naught, and then after loading, we have to perform the operation. We have to do add R naught comma 50, and then we do store a comma R naught. So this is the first operation is called as the read operation. The second operation is called as is the operation which we are performing, and the third operation is called as the write operation. That means whatever data we want to do, we are writing that data onto the data variable. Okay, so you already know that according to the CPU architecture, we have different different architectures, where we have accumulator machine architecture, even we have register file architecture, different types of architectures which are present. So if you want to perform some operation on data item A, then first of all we are going to load the value of data item A onto a register, and then we are going to perform that operation onto the register, and then we are going to store the value of that operation that register onto the onto the same variable again. So here we have done the lost update problem, and again you can see for every transaction, even if you do want to do a is equal to a plus 50, and this will be broken down to three steps, that is read, operation and write. And here this is representing the same operation, assuming that we have some account. This is the account, and this account is containing around 1000 rupees initially. Now the transaction T1, assume this is Himanshu and this is Ravi. Okay, so this transaction T1 wants to subtract, or wants to take 50 rupees out of this account. So first of all, it is going to read the value of A. So this value of A will be stored inside a register, and the register will know that now the value of A is 1000. And then see, between these two transactions, we can have preemption, right? So if you remember the concept of operating system, in case of operating system, we understood that there are two types of system. We can have preemptive algorithm. We can have preemptive algorithm as well as we can have non-preemptive algorithm. Preemptive algorithm is like we have round robin algorithm. Round robin algorithm was a purely preemptive algorithm. We have SRTF algorithm, that is shortest remaining time first algorithm. And even the other algorithms like priority based algorithm, these algorithms can also work on a preemptive manner. And when I'm saying non-preemptive algorithm means, if a process is inside the CPU, then we cannot take the process out of the CPU unless it completes its execution, or can say unless it completes its task. Okay, so let me repeat it again. When I'm saying preemption means, if this is a CPU, if one process is executing inside the CPU, and if there's a higher priority process P2 is coming, then we can take the P1 process out of the CPU, and then we can give this P2 process inside the CPU. And when I'm in the round robin algorithm, we perform this for a time quantum. So before taking this course, that is concurrent execution, I prefer that you should go through this topic from operating system, where in operating system we studied what is synchronization, and we studied the different mechanisms. Like we have studied deadlock, what is synchronization, and what are the different synchronization mechanisms and algorithms which are present. Okay, so now you can see, and one more thing is, that is CPU scheduling, that is also required. Now what can happen here, if this is the account If this is the account A and it is containing 1000 rupees, initially the transaction T1 read the value of account A, so that means it is going to store that value inside the register R0, and then it is going to do A is equal to A minus 50, that means inside this register R0 it is going to make it 950. Okay, then assuming that there's a preemption here, there's a preemption. Preemption means we are taking T1 transaction out of the CPU and we are putting T2 transaction or T2 inside the CPU or T2 process inside the CPU. Now the T2 process also reading the value of A. The value of A is still 1000. T2 will also read the value of A as 1000, right? And then we are going to do X is equal to A star 0.4. That means we are going to calculate 0.4 of this 1000, and this 0.4 of this 1000 is representing 40. Okay, and then we do A is equal to A plus X. So inside the register, assume it is maintaining the register R1, inside this register R1 we are going to store 1000 plus 40 as 1040, and assume there's again a preemption here and CPU is again given to the transaction T1. Now T1 has already calculated its value. Now it is going to store this value inside this variable, that is 950 will be stored here. And after that, again, because it completed the T1 transaction completed its task, so the CPU is again given to the transaction, which is T2, and T2 is also going to write its value. That means T2 is going to write A, and the value which is calculated by T2 is now 1040. So this 1040 will be stored here. Now you can see what is happening here in this specific case, that if the transactions are working parallelly, then there may be some kind of issues which are created. Okay, and you see here it is not 40, it should be 14400. So this should be 1400. So T2 will be writing 1400 into this. Okay, now you can see if these two transactions are working parallelly with each other, then on parallel execution, during parallel execution, and due to we have concurrency, and because of concurrency, and there is one more issue, that is preemption, these two transactions may give a different result. It should give a different result, but instead of we should have done 950 and 0.4 of 950. Now instead of doing that, this transaction is updating the value which is 1400, and this 1400 is a wrong value. Right, in the same way, there are a lot of issues which can happen. Assuming just for the same example, I'm just giving one more example here. Assuming this is a person P1 and this is a person P2, and this is the same account which is having the value which is storing 1000 rupees. Now P1 want to deposit 500 rupees inside the account, and P2 want to subtract 500 rupees out of the account. So P1 is going to read the value of this account. So it is going to read, yes, account is containing 1000 rupees. Assume there's a preemption, then P2 come. Then P2 is also reading the value of the account. It is also reading that there are 500 rupees in the account. Then assuming the CPU is again given to P1, and P1 is reading that this account is containing, P1 is going to perform its operation. So it is going to do 1000 minus plus 500. So it is going to say that 1500 should be written, but it is not writing it yet. So both of them read that 1000 rupees are there in the account. So P1 also read 1000 rupees is there. P2 also read 1000 rupees is there. Then P2 is going to subtract this 500 rupees from the account. So P2 is going to see that 500 rupees should be written. Then assuming that CPU is again given to P1, and P1 is going to write its operation. So P1 is going to write 1500 inside the account. But after that, there's again a preemption, and if CPU is given to P2, and P2 is also is going to write 500 rupees in the account, that means this 1500 rupees will be overwritten by P2. Okay, so this value will be overwritten. Okay, this overwritten, why it is overwritten is happening because there's some kind of a race condition which is occurring here. Race condition means the order of execution of these two statements, or can say the order of execution of these two transactions is going to define that what will be the result of this transaction, right? So you can see if P1 finishes first, then we are going to write 1500, and that 1500 value will be overwritten by P2. Now if P2 finishes first, and then we are going to write 500, but that 500 value will be overwritten by P1. So then in this account we'll be storing 1500. Okay, so this is the difference between these two transactions. So you can say the way these transactions are executing their operations, or you can say the order in which these transactions are executing their operations, that is going to define what is the end result of this particular transaction. Okay, so now let us see what are the different problems which we can face in the transaction and concurrency management. Okay, and when I'm saying transaction means transaction is a unit of work. Okay, transaction is unit of work. That means either all these operations should be done or they should not be done. Okay, and when I'm saying schedule means how these operations are happening and how the CPU scheduling these operations. Okay, now let us look at some of the more problems which we can face when we're doing concurrent execution of the transactions.